In this video, Ruben is going to introduce you to our SaaS Analytics Stack series. All the more coming up. Hello there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com, teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today we got Ruben back on the channel. Now, Ruben runs Practical Analytics, where he helps businesses to figure out which tools should they use for the different uses of analytics in their businesses, at what stage the customer actually is at, and what data you can track. And he helps, obviously, also with the implementation. Now, while chatting with Ruben, I was super interested in what tools he would recommend for a SaaS business or a software as a service business that has recurring revenue. Since there is not just one tool to rule them all, he made a whole video series for us, which we are gonna release on this channel in the coming weeks. Now, he's gonna cover everything from tools that you would use to actually track the acquisition of the customer until to the retention of the customer and which metrics you should pay attention to. In this video, we are gonna get a brief introduction to his framework that he uses. And then in the next video, we're gonna dive right into the tools that he would recommend. Now, we got lots to cover. So Ruben, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. And welcome to the SaaS Analytics Stack series that we'll be going over here over the short little while. My name is Ruben, and I'm the founder of Practical Analytics, and we specialize in helping software companies, especially fast-growing software companies, really set up the right data foundation in place. This typically means we come in and we help them design a stack that helps them cover some of the most fundamental questions, you know, what marketing campaigns are driving the best users, what's going on with the product, are users actually the users actually love the product, are they being retained, all those kind of things. And what we came up with this series is we have a handful of videos here, about three or four videos. And we'll be looking at all the series, you know, a typical journey that a user will go through when they want to use your SaaS product. And we'll cover some of the different tools, reports, events, data tracking, all those different things that you should be considering when you build out your stack. And, you know, some of the metric here is that typically a lot of companies want one tool that can do everything, and that'd be really great. In an analytics world, that's still not quite the case. So you're really still going to end up with multiple tools, a stack of sorts, to be able to answer all the questions that you need. And I'll cover what the tools are. Now, some notes or some things to keep in mind as you go through these videos. Really, there's lots of tools out there. Really, there's hundreds of options. So whenever I mention the tool, I'll give you other options if you prefer to explore those. So you don't have to pick the exact recommendations I mentioned. On the other hand, you also want to keep it small, right? So keep your stack small. I think, you know, our final stack will be about four or five tools. That's something that's manageable. You could probably compress a little bit more, maybe to three tools. So you want to start small always, you know, especially if you don't have anything. You start with a handful of events, build upon those, a small amount of tools, build upon those, and so on. Don't just try to go big and be like, hey, you know, we're doing this, we might as well do it big, which is things that companies tackle. So really want to tackle small and get value out of it, right? If you have a priority in your company, if you say, hey, next 6 months, acquisition is a big priority, you could probably just cover that step, the step that I'll cover there, and just start with those events, those tools, and then eventually you come back and tackle retention and onboarding and those different things. You don't have to tackle everything at once. With that being said, we'll jump to the first video where we'll talk about acquisition and some of the acquisition data that you can be tracking for your SaaS product, some of the tools, some of the events, reports, and so on. And then from there, we'll start. So I'll see you in the next video.
All right, so there you have it, a brief introduction to our SaaS Analytics Stack series here on this channel. If you want to follow along, you can click on the next video right over there, where we're gonna talk about acquisition and which tools you should use to track this correctly. And if you want to keep up to date with all the videos that come out on the channel and also the future videos of this series, definitely subscribe to our channel and click that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on anything that we do here. Now, my name is Julian. See you in the next one.